The show you are about to see was videotaped by Ernie Kovacs on December 3rd for Dutch Master Cigars at the ABC Studios in Hollywood. We have received numerous requests from as many fans to televise this show. That is why we present it tonight. Ernie wanted it to be seen and enjoyed.
The various art forms are playing an important part of our lives in this generation, and the artists, poets, musicians of our era have made tremendous strides forward. We've arranged to visit some of the more noted exponents of their crafts, and our first visit is with America's deep-feeling master of the descriptive phrase, poet Tension Brett. Here in Mr. Brett's suburban apartment is the birthplace of some of America's most beautiful poetry. Mr. Brett?
Yes.
I see you are rather deep in thought. Is it possibly on your current project?
Yes, an epic poem of esoteric meter.
What do you call it?
My epic poem?
Yes.
Dearth.
Dearth?
Dearth. May I read it for you?
Please do.
Dearth. Dearth the lack. O sheaves of wheat by wind, west wind, whoso, what with all, shall and yet those who can or will not.
There's a great deal of truth in that, Mr. Brett.
Verdad, 11 years of work, but not to unavail.
11 years is a great dedication to a work.
The title took 5 years alone.
Do you have any other works we might discuss?
I do have a somewhat humorous piece, if I'm making no imposition.
Oh, not at all. That's why we're here. Well, what do you call this funny one?
A boss. A boss, and yet it was tintinnabulation. Wild of drum and leather thong, O ye welkin, welkin ye, canst ply thy cobbler to hail and hammer, hail, nail. 21, 21, oh, to vote again, so leapt my heart.
That's a real rib tickler, Mr. Brett. How do you compare this with dearth?
Oh, not at all. Dearth is rooty, deep in root. A boss is a fillip of fancy, a flight, a poet's holiday kind of thing.
Well, it's been delightful visiting. We'll be looking forward to the publication of Dearth.
Verdad.
Our next visit is with America's famed painter, Mother Rustic. Mother Rustic, I see you're hard at work in your kitchen.
Land sakes, I didn't expect to see you so soon. Yeah, the men folk will be in from the fields in a half hour or so, and they'll be mighty hungry. Boy, that plowing, and sowing and reaping sure works up appetites. I just milked 40 black Anguses myself. Sure beats squeezing a tennis ball for building a grip. I can crack walnuts with my cuticles. Name your finger.
Well, I'm sure you can, Mother Rustic.
You ought to drop in during the pig killing. You can't turn around without bumping into a stack of spare ribs or a mess of pork chops. I killed 80 pigs last year with one shot apiece with a croquet mallet. Land sakes, we had more fun. Yeah.
I like roast pig very much, but when do you find time to paint?
Oh, well, my favorite time is just about when I get finished slopping the hogs. That's when I get a good north light.
Well, what subjects do you paint?
Well, I like to paint what I know. You know, local stuff. Stuff you see around you all the time. It's the only stuff I know, I guess.
May we see some of your paintings?
Oh, land sakes. Well, they ain't much. But if you like, come over this way. This here one is one I done of our old silo. I call it old silo. This here one is sheep. I guess it's pretty silly putting obvious titles on them. Sheepdog and wolf. Newborn calf. Poor little critter died last year. It's the only picture we have of her. This here one is spring plowing. County fair. Hoedown. And this last one here, I think, is just about my best. When day is done. Oh, land sakes, I've been here chewing too long. Them men folks should be sitting down. And then, Chow time! Come and get it! Chow time! Chow time!
The art of sculpture, too, has seen considerable progress. Since neophyte sculptors gazed in awe at Michelangelo's David, Rodin's Thinker, and the countless other fine representations of the human form in stone, the sculptor stands alone, for it is only he with his chisel who turns cold, stark marble into the rippling arteries of human life. Let us stop in at the studio of the noted Hungarian sculptor, Miklos Molnár.
Mr. Molnár, forgive our interruption, but all America is interested in your work. I said, forgive our interruption.
I heard that part. What was the last part?
All America is interested in your work. What is that you're working on?
What do you think? Chicken paprikash. It's a statue.
I know that, Mr. Molnár. I mean, what do you call it?
Like everybody else call it a statue. What do you think?
Well, I think our viewers would be particularly interested...
Tell your nuts viewers to go watch Popeye cartoons on TV.
Sir,
you know... What's wrong? You got something nuts upstairs?
Sir, it's just that you've been the exponent of so many new phases of sculpture. For instance, why do you have that large hole in this statue?
I make mistake. What do you think? I'm nuts? I put hole in statue? You know people what got hole in statue? They die in stomach? They die 6 minutes. They could not breathe, they could not eat. What's the matter? You're nuts upstairs?
Well, sir,
look,
it's
take
just
your,
that I...
Please go, take your TV camera, get out, please.
But, sir, I... Sir? Sir, are...
Mother!
Are you stuck, sir?
Mother! I'm stuck! Mother, where's my wife? Mother! Mother!
Let us not, in this coverage of the contemporary artisan, overlook the men behind the scenes, the guards at the Museum of Art, the restorers of old paintings, the maintenance men of mammoth works of sculpture. Alternate sponsor. Try a box today. I've had one great privilege on these shows, and that is in more or less foistering off on you one of the things that is very close to me, and that is good music. I'm particularly bugged on one great composer, Bela Bartok. I think that Bartok writes things that we will comprehend many years from now a great deal more than we do today, the things that he has written. I think possibly the greatest piece of music that Bartok ever wrote was his concerto for orchestra. We did the concerto on one of our programs several months ago, and that single piece of music received more mail than any other, and in more or less response to your enthusiasm, we'd like to do it again for you tonight.
der Haifisch, der hat Zähne und die trägt er im Gesicht. Und McKees, der hat ein Messer, und das Messer sieht man nicht. Und McKees, der hat ein Messer, doch das Messer sieht man nicht. Und die Männer, ihr Wettere, deren Namen jeder weiß, wachte auf und war geschändet.
The show you have just seen was videotaped by Ernie Kovacs on December 3rd for Dutch Masters Cigars. It was made to be seen and enjoyed. Because commercials were eliminated, the show is run several minutes short. In the time remaining, we'd like to show you one of Ernie's favorite sketches from a previous show.
Do.
Me.
Do.
In these words, the Reverend Dr. Samuel Ellison paid final tribute to Ernie Kovacs. We love this man. He gave joy, happiness, and gaiety to the world. He was a rugged individualist, a creative genius, but he was always ready to listen and slow to judge.
The Invaders will not be seen tonight because of the following special program. Watch The Invaders next week at its usual time.
Yes!
Comedy of Ernie Kovacs, brought to you by Consolidated Cigar Corporation, makers of Dutch Masters cigars. Step up to finer smoking pleasure with Dutch Masters, the fine cigar.
Ach, es sind des Haifischflossen, rot wenn dieser Blut vergießt, Mackie Messer trägt den Hand. Drauf man keine Untat liest. An dem schönen blauen Sonntag liegt ein toter Mann am Strand und ein Mensch geht um die Ecke, den man Mackie Messer nennt. Und Schmulmeier bleibt verschwunden und so mancher reiche Mann. Und sein Geld hatte Mackie Messer
John.
And now, Dutch Master Cigars presents Stump the Masters, the exciting panel show starring our famous talking trademark, the Dutch Masters. And now, here's Barbara with our first guest. Yours? Let's see if you can beat our panel and guess his secret.
This'll be easy. Sir, you look very familiar. Does your secret have anything to do with cherry trees?
I cannot tell a lie. No.
He's lying.
I know his secret. You're the owner of a big bridge.
No.
I know. You're famous because the capital is named after you. Columbus, Ohio.
I got it. Your secret is we named a cigar after you.
Hamill, you are right.
The Dutch Master Washington.
No, the Dutch Master's president. The largest selling 15-cent cigar in America today.
I'm going to vote for him.
It's true. Its size is more generous. And that's one reason why the Dutch Master's president is so popular.
Thank you very much, Mr. Washington. Friends, tune in again to Stump the Masters. And when you're ready for a better cigar, step up to milder Dutch Masters.
They don't call us masters for nothing.
ERNIE KOVACS, actor, writer, director, producer. He said of his own comedy, "I work on the incongruity of sight against sound." He explored the sound, sights, lights, and electronic effects of television to create a unique brand of humor and visual excitement long before the popularity of light shows and psychedelic art. His ideas and techniques, which represent more than a decade of television pioneering, are now finding wide acceptance. The material in this show was selected from programs which appeared on ABC TV under Dutch Master's sponsorship in 1961 and 1962. ERNIE KOVACS was one of television's originals.
We'll be right back.
not only because the television industry is determined to bring enlightening and important events to the public, but because the guest who is about to appear with us has a story to tell that I think will be of interest to all of you watching. Normally, we do not use a straight interview on these half hours, but I felt that you'd be interested in hearing the fascinating and exciting story that Mr. Albert Gridley has to tell. Mr. Gridley's story is one he will never forget.
Yes, it is etched into my mind forever. It is as if it happened yesterday.
Tell us your story, Mr. Gridley.
Well, I was one of...
One of five children.
Yes, one of five children who came out...
West with your father and mother.
Yes, with my father and mother. We were in the middle of the desert. I'll never forget what happened that day. It was on the...
Fifth day.
Yes, fifth day after we left.
And wasn't the sun beating down?
Yes, the sun was beating down. And it was hot.
And, did your 1918 Stutz Bearcat have motor trouble?
Yes, my 1918 Stutz Bearcat had motor trouble. It was...
Terrible.
Terrible. Yes, I'll never forget what Dad said. Dad said...
Did your father tell you to go to the nearest town and get a fan belt?
Yes, Father said to go to the nearest town and get a new fan belt. My four sisters.
They were Alice, Mabel, Myrtle, and Bessie.
Yes, Alice, Mabel, Myrtle, and Bossie.
Bessie.
Yes, Bessie.
What did your sisters do?
They...
Did they stay behind in the car while you went in town for the fan belt?
They stayed behind in the car while I went in town for the fan belt.
And what happened in town while you were getting the fan belt? What happened to Myrtle?
Myrtle?
Your sister.
Yes, Myrtle, my sister. I'll never forget it. A wolf.
Did a rattlesnake bite your sister Myrtle?
Yes, a rattlesnake bit my sister Myrtle. On the arm?
Leg.
Yes, on the leg. I'll never forget it. It was terrible.
And then your father killed the snake, and when you came back from town with the fan belt, you fixed the car and drove off to settle in California, and everything went well after that.
Yes. Like you said.
Well, thank you for coming on our program tonight, Mr. Gridley. You had a wonderful and exciting story to tell, one that has lived with you every moment.
Yes, I'll never forget it. It is etched into my memory.
Mona Lisa, tak cię zowią, to tak tajemniczy, piękny uśmiech masz? To dlatego, żeś ty zawsze jest samotny.
Smoking pleasure with Dutch Masters, the fine cigar.
Ty się śmiejesz, by uwodzić Mona Lisa. Czy też ukryć chcesz ten ból, co w sercu masz? Wiele snów u twych stóp.
Resintes, Haifisch Flossen, Rot, wenn dieser Blut vergießt, Mackie Messer trägt den Handschuh.
I wonder how many times you've said to yourself, or perhaps to a neighbor, I just wish there were some method of keeping my carbonated beverages in the bottle. Well, I know just what you mean. We've all had this problem at one time or another. But your worries about spilling carbonated and non-carbonated beverages are now over. The next time you want to keep those carbonated and non-carbonated beverages in the bottle, try using a cork. Now watch this simple test. This is Brand X, the bottle without a cork in it. Notice how the beverage spills out of the bottle. There's always the danger of wetting clothing, car seats, a saddle if you're a cowpoke. This is Brand Q, the bottle with a cork in it. Proof that a cork keeps the beverage from spilling out of the bottle. Well, Bobby, how many bottles do you have with corks in them?
We put a cork in each bottle.
How many cavities do you have?
None. Like I said, we put a cork in each bottle.
Joe, you didn't use any corks. How did you make out?
Not so good.
More proof that a cork really works. Marvin L. Kosnowski, president of Kosnowski Corks, is proud of his corks.
I am proud of my corks.
Ask your friendly cork dealer for a trial cork today.
Our next visit is with America's famed painter, Mother Rustic. Mother Rustic, I see you're hard at work in your kitchen.
Land sakes, I didn't expect to see you so soon. Yeah, the men folk will be in from the fields in a half hour or so, and they'll be mighty hungry. Boy, that plowing, sowing, and reaping sure works up appetites. Just milked 40 black Anguses myself. Sure be squeezing a tennis ball for building a grip. I can crack walnuts with my cuticles. Name your finger.
Well, I'm sure you can, Mother Rustic.
You ought to drop in during the pig killing. You can't turn around without bumping into a stack of spare ribs or a mess of pork chops. I killed 80 pigs last year with one shot apiece with a croquet mallet. Land sakes, we had more fun. Yeah.
I like roast pig very much, but when do you find time to paint?
Oh, well, my favorite time is just about when I get finished slopping the hogs. That's when I get a good north light.
Well, what subjects do you paint?
Well, I like to paint what I know. You know, local stuff. Stuff you see around you all the time. It's the only stuff I know, I guess.
May we see some of your paintings?
Oh, land sakes. They ain't much. But if you like, come over this way. This here one is one I done of our old silo. I call it Old Silo. This here one is sheep. I guess it's pretty silly putting obvious titles on them. Sheepdog and wolf. Newborn calf. Poor little critter died last year. It's the only picture we have of her. This here one is spring plowing. County fair, hoedown. And this last one here, I think, is just about my best. When day is done. Oh, land sakes, I've been here chewing too long. Them menfolk should be sitting down. And then, chow time, come and get it. Chow time!
Trägt im Gesicht.
Dom.
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 sol, do, mi, do, fa, re, sol, sol. Mi, sol, la, re, fa, re, sol, do, mi, do, fa, re, sol, sol, do. Do, mi, fa, si, re, si, mi, la, do, la, fa, re, sol, sol. Do, mi, do, fa, si, re, si, mi, la, do, la, fa, re, sol, sol.
Slipped a brown martini in on me here. Or perhaps it's that faffy bartender using mascara again. To business. I have received here a short communication from a student who says, we have been studying history. We are studying the stories of Mr. Americus Vespucci and Mr. Christopher Columbus and how they discovered the world was round. Would you please explain how they did discover it was round? Actually, it's not round at all. People are dropping off all the time. That is tasty, isn't it? Oh, I pity the abstainer. Seems to be quite a bit missing. Perhaps that stuffed olive is soaking it up. And maybe the daisy has got a hollow stem. You can't trust the daisy. But you never know, because they say daisies won't tell. Here's another communication on the other side of this. Dear Mr. Dovetonsel, in my chemistry class, my chemistry teacher keeps changing my seat. So much for that. Now then, all over the country, it is autumn, it is fall. And certainly the leaves are beginning to pile up on the sidewalk. And old Jack Frost is nipping, because he's human too. Here's you, Jack. So I have written a poem called Autumn. That one was on camera, the first one I missed. Oh, Adam and Eve wore fig leaves in the earliest of Earth's known years. They wore them through spring and through summer, labeling them his and hers. You talk about your poetic license, huh? They caught dreadful colds, though, soon after, at least historians so recall. The fig leaves were swell in the summer. Well, what happened to those leaves in the fall?
Lisa, Mona Lisa, tak cię zowią, bo tak tajemniczy, piękny uśmiech masz. To dlatego, żeś ty zawsze jest samotna. Mony Lisy, uśmiech zdobi twoją twarz. Czy się uśmiejesz?
Dutch Master Cigars presents Stump the Masters, the exciting panel show starring the men every cigar smoker loves, the Dutch Masters. Now, here's Barbara with our first guest. Okay, viewers and panel, it's up to you to figure out why our guests are so happy.
Well, I'd be happy, too, if I had a lovely girl like Barbara on my arm.
Well, I would say that you are from a warm and sunny clime, right?
Oh, very observant, very observant. Don't look like a penguin, do I?
Tobacco grows where it's warm and sunny, huh?
Our guest is a tobacco grower.
And we are so happy because my tobacco is good enough for the Dutch Master cigars.
Of course you're happy, because we buy only the milder, better tobacco, you know.
Everyone knows that. Say, where do you fellas get your hair done?
Tune in again to Stump the Masters. And remember, friends, when you're ready for a better cigar, step up to milder Dutch Masters.
They don't call us masters for nothing.
die trägt er im Gesicht. Und Mekis, der hat sein Messer, doch das Messer sieht man nicht. Ach, es sind der...
My heart again. the taste of the panatella from Honolulu.
Dutch Masters come in 11 different shapes.
Okay, on the taste of the Perfecto from San Antonio.
If you wanted to prove a point, you could go around the country tasting them.
Okay, on the Eldorado from Nome.
You'd find that every Dutch Masters has the same high quality.
Okay, on the Corona Deluxe from Seattle.
With so many cigars to choose from today, we want ours to be the best we can make. And they are.
Okay, on the President from Miami.
But don't take our word for it. Try a pack of Dutch Masters yourself. Any shape, anywhere.
Okay, on Dutch Masters from Chicago.
Here's great news for small cigar smokers. Dutch Masters mild-mannered cadets have a new low price. 5 for only 35 cents, tipped or regular. Forward march to your nearest cigar counter.
Ty się śmiejesz, by uwodzić Mona Lisa. Czy też ukryć chcesz ten ból, co w sercu ma?
Dunka! He is off in the court! Zemberg! Zemberg!
Zemberg! One tam są i tam umrą.
Color specials make tomorrow a special night on ABC. The fascinating world of single people will be explored on The Great Mating Game. Then spend a tuneful hour with Wayne Newton on One More Time. And top off your evening with television's most exciting star-studded event, the Academy Award presentations with Bob Hope as Master of Ceremonies. Tomorrow night on ABC.
John?
comedy of Ernie Kovacs was brought to you by Dutch Master Cigars, a product of Consolidated Cigar Corporation, a Gulf and Western company.
It's a baby deer. I wonder if it's lost.
An Easter Seal camp lets handicapped children find out what nature is all about. Please, give to Easter Seals.
Comedian Tody Field sits in for vacationing Joey Bishop tonight. Among her guests are songstress Sarah Vaughan, comic Corbett Monica, and physical fitness expert Debbie Drake. For 90 minutes of great late-night entertainment, enjoy the Joey Bishop Show. Just 30 minutes from now, in color on ABC.